for this hour of prayer. Father God, we thank you because you've been good to us, and we ask you, Lord, to come in and stir our hearts, stir our mind, Lord. And Lord, we ask you, Lord, to step in and have your way in this service today. Father, we ask you to touch each and every one, touch their mind, touch their hearts. God, you know what we need, and God, we ask you, Lord, rain down in our heart, to rain down in this service with your anointing upon us at this moment in time. And we thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, amen. First of all, I'd like to say today that it is good to be in the house again, amen, to serve the Lord. Amen. We have to believe that we are in God's house. Amen. Because God is the one and is the reason why we're here. Amen. Because we love the Lord from our heart. Amen. It's good to praise him, and it's good to magnify him, and it's good to let somebody know that you love the Lord. Amen. We thank God for this, the first Sunday of June. Amen. And we thank God for allowing us to see another Sunday. Amen. I'm here today to give you the word of God. Amen. To let the word of God, amen, change the way that you're thinking. Change the way that you're walking. Change the way that you're living in your life. But I'm here today to let you know that we love the Lord. Amen. And I'm going to the book. Go to the book of Psalm 51, chapter and the 10th verse. 51 chapter and the 10th verse. Amen. That's way that you understand where I'm coming from today, amen, in our message on today, even in the word of the Lord, amen. At this time, it read the word of the Lord, created in me a clean heart, O God, a renewed and steadfast spirit within me, amen. God want us to have a clean heart. Amen. A clean heart and a clean spirit and a, amen, and a transfer mind. Amen. That's what he said in his word. Amen. My test today is a pure heart. Amen. God want us to have a pure heart. Somebody out there, amen, don't have a heart, amen, to love one another. But today you're going to have a reason, amen, and you're going to realize that it is necessary to have a pure heart to love one another. Amen. We talk about our subject today, but other than that, we have other words that would help us in a pure heart. But other words, the Bible said that our heart are the course of beginning according to the Bible. We live from our heart. That is why we should love God first of all with our heart, whole heart. Amen. He should be at the center of our destiny, emotionally, feeling, through the habit, and should establish our entire, amen, beginning. It started in the house. Come on and say, in the house. Amen. It started from you. It started from yourself. It started because that you would have to believe that your heart will be purified. Amen. Your heart will be pure to one another. Amen. You have to have the heart to be able to, amen, to love God. Amen. If you love God, it's not no problem for you to love each other. It's not no problem to love one another. Because you have that pure heart. Somebody out there don't have that pure heart. Somebody out there don't have that love in the heart. Somebody out there don't have that emotion. And let him work it out for our good. Amen. We thank God for that. Because we know that God is real. How many of them know that God is real? He's a real mighty God. Amen. He's an awesome God, and he know how to work things out for you. Amen. Amen. He make everything all right for you. He put a big smile on your face. Amen. And I'm good that you know the Lord, because he heard your cry. Sometimes you feel like crying sometimes because the way the things are going like it are. But I'm here to tell you that stay encouraged. Don't be dismayed. But hang in there because God got helpers on the way. God loves you so much. He know how to put things in place when we don't know how to put it in place. God know what to do and how to do it. We got to stand in the gap and trust God and let him work it out for us. Somebody out there is weeping and crying. Wonder why. How is this going to work out? How is this going to do? But I'm here to tell you, don't worry. God got your back. Don't worry. God should see you through. Don't worry. God know how to keep you on your two feet. All you got to do is call on him. You can call on him day and night. Come on and say yes. He gets to the 36th and 26th verse. I will give you a new heart. And I give you a new spirit. I will put within you. And I will remove the heart of stone from the flesh. And give you a heart of flesh. Thank God for the glory. Get God to do anything. He will make things all right. You got to understand. God can do it all. You got to hold up to God's hand. And let God begin to work in your behalf. Let him stand before you. And say, Lord, I can't do this by myself. I need you, Lord. I need you and I want you, Lord. Purify my heart. Purify my mind. Give me what I need to have. When I can be able to stand in the glory. Because the coming of the Lord. Whoa, Lord. Come on and say, thank the Lord. A pure heart. A pure heart. Make the difference in your life. A pure heart. Make everything all right. When God got you in his hand, your mind and your heart will be pure unto God. Come on and say yeah. Thank you, Lord. And the Bible says in the book of Matthew 5:8 verse, it said, blessed are the pure in the heart, for they will see the Lord. Oh, thank the Lord. Knowing that your heart is pure. Don't let nobody stop you from letting your heart be pure. Don't let nobody stop you from walking with God. Don't let nobody stop you from coming and give God some praise. Don't let nobody stop you from giving God some praise. Because he is the reason why I give him the praise. Come on and say yeah. The praise shall be continued. Be in my mouth. Nobody else. So stop me from opening my mouth. Because when I open it up, I give God some holy praise. Because God is. He is what he say. He give me a clean mind. A clean heart. A clean walk. A clean spirit. I can walk day by day. And sing a song. Sing a song. All day long. He walk with me. All day long. Yeah. Woo. Thank the Lord. Come on and give God some praise. God is awesome. God is real. How many of you know he's real? He's real from your heart. You gotta speak out to him. You gotta reach out for him. Because the spirit of the heart. Go out for the law. Because God will bring you out. You just trust him. If you can't trust nobody else. But you just trust the law. And he will hold you up. Because your heart has desire. To live for the law. Your heart has to go all the way with him. Your heart. Come on and say your heart. Thank the Lord. Have a pure heart. Thank the Lord. Have a good heart. I'm talking about a good heart. Everybody don't have a good heart. But I'm here to tell you, when you got Jesus in your life, you will have a good heart. When you walk in his spirit, and when you don't have his spirit, but when you get his spirit, you're going to have a good heart. Because God, God, come on and say God, will help you to have a good heart. Yes, Lord. Yeah, come on and say yeah, he's all right. Glory, 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 glory. And give us some praise in here, because somebody wants the praise of the pure heart, because that's how God works. He works like a mighty wind. He's working like a mighty strong. All we got to do is hold the God. Lord, I feel like clapping my head. I feel like clapping now. Because the Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost is in this room. The Holy Ghost is in my spirit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lift him up. Come on and praise the Lord. I'm waiting on you to give me some praise. Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
This morning, if you know that your heart is right, you got to.